you so much. You translating? Yes. You know, careers are a funny thing. They can pivot on the tiniest decision or the littlest twist of fate. For me, 30 years ago, almost 30 years ago exactly, I was sitting in my apartment with my wife, we were newlyweds, and the telephone rang. It was a phone call, a simple phone call. And it turned out it was this tiny little tech company called Pixar that was calling to see if I might be interested to come up to the San Francisco area to help edit a movie that they were starting to make.
Moltes gràcies. Les carreres professionals tenen, són de vegades es desenvolupen d'una manera una mica graciosa o curiosa. De vegades depenen d'una decisió molt petita o d'un gir del destí. Fa uns anys, quan estava en el meu apartament amb la meva dona, vaig rebre aquesta trucada de telèfon d'una petita companyia tecnològica anomenada Pixar, que em convidava a anar a San Francisco, a l'àrea de San Francisco, a editar una de les seves pel·lícules.
It of course was Toy Story. First Toy Story. And I had no idea at the time that that phone call was literally going to completely change the course of my life. I went up and worked on Toy Story, and it was an amazing experience because we all knew that we were creating something that was different than the world had ever seen before.
Aquesta pel·lícula era Toy Story i no tenia ni idea de que aquesta experiència canviaria completament la meva vida. Sabíem que estàvem fent amb Toy Story una cosa increïble, que era diferent.
So that phone call may have been a twist of fate, but I actually had a decision later that ended up being kind of just as monumental. When I finished Toy Story, and we sent it out into the world, it was a great success, critically and commercially, I was asked if I would stay and keep making movies at Pixar. And it sounds crazy now to think I would have said no, but it was something that I thought about long and hard because I had always imagined when I went through film school that I would be making live-action films. And I thought that making Toy Story was just a really fun, interesting diversion. And that when it was done, I would move back to Los Angeles and continue on the path that I thought was in front of me.
Així que aquesta trucada de telèfon no va ser un gir del destí, però sí va ser una decisió monumental en el meu cas. Quan vam llançar Toy Story va ser un gran èxit i llavors em van demanar si em volia quedar a Pixar per fer més pel·lícules. Potser ara sona una mica una bogeria, però m'ho vaig pensar, perquè no tenia idea o no tenia al cap la idea de seguir fent animació, sinó pel·lícules de live action.
And what I finally decided, obviously, was to stay at Pixar. And I decided that because I realized that I had a really unique opportunity to work on films that I thought and hoped would be lasting, that generations later, and maybe even long after I was gone, people would still be watching those movies and people would still be affected by them. And here we are 30 years later, and that's exactly true. I still run into people constantly who thank me for making the most important films of their childhood, but also people who thank me for making films that helped them get through the death of a loved one with Coco. So it's been a continual gift to not only, you know, have the honor of having been a part of all these films, but that they stay a huge part of my life and they stay a huge part of everybody's lives.
Finalment em vaig decidir a quedar-me a Pixar perquè vaig pensar que era una oportunitat única de fer pel·lícules que duressin el temps, que les generacions futures poguessin veure, i és el que està passant en realitat. Estem aquí 30 anys més tard amb gent que em dona les gràcies per haver fet aquestes pel·lícules que recorden de la seva infància, per haver-los ajudat a enfrontar-se a la pèrdua de persones estimades per fer Coco. I llavors el que puc dir és que és un honor doncs mantenir aquestes pel·lícules i que siguin part, una part important de la vida de les persones i de la meva vida.
So I stand here today because one day my phone rang. It's as simple as that. And I've gotten to do a lot of things in my life because the phone rang that day. And in fact, my wife, Laura, who's here tonight, can attest that at many of these moments throughout our lives, we turn to each other and just say phone call. Because we know that nothing that is in our lives would have happened without the phone call. I won my first Oscar. I came back to my seat with the Oscar and I turned to her and said, phone call.
Per tant, sóc aquí avui gràcies a aquesta trucada de telèfon. He fet el que he fet i sóc el que sóc per aquesta trucada. De fet, amb la meva dona, la Laura, amb qui he compartit tot aquest temps, quan alguna cosa passa ens mirem i diem trucada de telèfon. És el que va passar quan vaig guanyar l'Òscar, el meu primer Òscar. Ens mirem i diem trucada de telèfon. I no tindríem el que tenim avui dia si no fos per aquesta trucada.
So, thank you to you, Angel. Thank you to the Sitges Film Festival. It's a great honor. I'm very happy to be here in this beautiful city at this amazing festival. And again, I wouldn't be standing here were it not for that phone call. Thank you.